Guys, it's Ross. Hope you're having a great day, and I think it's about time for a gardening video update. So let's have a look. This is the oregano I planted about 6 weeks ago. Now, it was quite windy when I was planting it, so I think it must have blown out of the thing, so I don't actually think any got planted, so I'll just recycle that and I'll use it to plant something else. The chamomile seems to be picking up again. It's not as good as it was when I first bought it, but it definitely seems to be picking up. Here are the lettuces, and they're definitely looking more lettucey. I don't know. I mean, they're quite big now. I think they might have to be replanted. Here are the cucumbers. They're looking very similar. I mean, they've grown quite a lot, but I don't know if you can see those. But in the middle, but there's buds coming up in the middle. So hopefully they should be open soon, so I've had a good water. There are the tomatoes, let me just zoom out. There's the tomatoes. The aubergines haven't came up yet. It's, like I said, it's been about... I planted them at the same time as the oregano, so I don't know if it's... They definitely went in, because they were quite big seeds. They definitely went in. So, I don't know if it might be something to do with the... time it was planted or just the seeds. They don't seem to be coming up. These are the tomatoes that are left over before I transferred them. But one thing that I have noticed is on these the leaves here and here, they seem to be slightly bleached. So I don't know whether they weren't getting enough water or where the sun was coming through the window, whether it was burning them. So if you know, please tell me. I hope it's not blight, because that's the same problem I had last year. But I don't think it is, because it hasn't gone sort of a blacky purpley colour. But yeah, the cucumber's doing very well, and so are the lettuces. I mean, look at that. So if you think any of this stuff needs to be repotted and you know anything about gardening, please do tell me. Now, for early April, I've got it on the tripod. For early April, stuff to be planted is I've got some beans to go in, and also courgettes. I can't remember whether I was going to do courgettes or not, so I'll have to see. Sweet peppers, I should have put them on before. I've put on the time for them to go outside. I mean, I think I might plant them just straight outside, or actually I might put sweet peppers in here. I could actually do that today, so I will film me doing that. But before I do that, let me just pop over to the potatoes. Now, these have shot up. I mean, look, they're massive. Now, I mean, you have to pile these up. I don't quite know how I'm going to do it, because I did it in a black sack. It's coming up in a pot, but not so well. There's still some little ones, but they've died off. But on this one thing I'm not sure about is the fact that I planted four potatoes in each pot. Now here it only looks like one's come up, but here I think all four have came up in this black sack, so I don't know whether to get rid of some of them. So I'm a bit worried if I leave all four in. The plan was to pick them off. I mean, it just seems a bit of a waste. But I don't know if I leave all four in, whether there might be a problem with whether the potatoes that do get produced, whether they'll be as big. So so I'm just going to plant some sweet peppers. So I'll be with you in a second. Right, so this is the sweet peppers going in. I'm going to plant two seeds in each pot. I'll bring the other pot across into the camera. So it needs to be an inch and a half deep, apparently. It's nice and warm in here, so hopefully they should do well. Right, so there's two. And I say if I put one in, that's going to blow away. So actually, I'll put it under the spade. Right, So I say if I put one in about here, one about here, and then I'll pick off the weakest one. This one. There's two. Now I think the problem that I've been doing at the moment is I've been, can I just give it a little water? The thing that I've been doing at the moment is I've been planting too many each thing, so they're not growing so big. So I'm just gonna start, I'm just gonna plant less. So what I get, I might get less plants, but I should get a higher crop. So if I put in one there, perhaps not that deep, one there, and one there, break up these soil clumps around it, yeah, and one there, so, oops, I've just let the seed packet go without the thing on it, so put that in there. So cover that over. I'll drop that one down into there. Let's give it a nice water. There's probably going to be quite a lot of videos coming at the moment, gardening type videos, because as you can see, I mean, it's raining a lot, but I mean, it's not too bad. It's nice and sunny. So yeah. Good tip for these, when you've opened them, if you've still got seeds in like I have now, is if you take a paper clip, if I put this down, I'll just sit you down on my chair. Trying to adjust you, wait a minute. Right, what I always do is I always take a paper clip like this, take the top, fold it over, and then just clip it in like that, and then it just goes in my tin full of many seeds, ready for the next time. And I've been saving these lolly sticks from ice lollies and stuff, so I'll use them for names. So yeah, they will. Those two pots will probably go. Well, let me just think. I'm trying to think about it. I don't know. I might put these tomatoes down here. Sort of my spare tomatoes in this tray here. I'll put them up there on top of there. So then I can have one there, and then I'll have the small one there where it's been sitting empty. So yeah. Thanks for watching. And see you on another great day like this. Thanks for watching. See you later. Bye.